The game starts with players logging on to their individual clients. Player 1 chooses to be Marcus the Thief, and simultaneously the second player chooses to be Briliac the Mage. In the game, the two players can go to different locations in the world. The thief wants to enter the brothel. The two players starts in a group. Therefore, Briliac has to choose if he wants to enter the brothel with Marcus. Briliac chooses not to join, and Marcus enters the brothel alone. Inside the brothel, Marcus talks to the wench. The event chosen by player 1 is talk to bar wench. The choices taken are displayed along with the responses from the NPC in this message box. Here we see the player 1 hears about some treasure hunting. At the same time as player 1 is in the brothel, the second player is entering the magician's quarters. Here he talks to the magician. Briliac introduces himself and hears about an amulet. The amulet is located in the temple. After learning this, the player chooses to leave the magician's quarters. Now the two players are grouped up again and chooses to join each other to go to the temple. Here they must agree to follow each other each step of the way. The last player accepts the choice made by the other player using the buttons that appear on his screen. In the temple, they enter the door. In this event, the thief will try to open the door. The mage, however, has an additional option to try to hurl a powerful spell against it. However, neither of these actions succeed in opening the door, as seen in the message box. We notice both descriptions of each player's actions are shown. Red text is one's own dialogue, and blue is the other player's. The green text is descriptions from NPCs or the environment. Now the two players venture back to seek out new information. Here the thief splits from the mage and goes to the brothel. New choices are made in the same event that was entered before. The wench would like to join Marcus to the temple. When the player exits, a new condition is in the right side, wench companion. Over at the other player's side, we are talking to the magician again. A new quest has appeared. Something is brewing at the brothel. We learn about this new information and promise to check it out. After leaving the magician, Briliac now has a key that might open the door at the temple. The two players are back together again and ready to venture to the temple. Marcus realizes that he has a new event that Briliac doesn't have. Here Marcus can let Briliac join him, and they start this event together. The wench talks of dark rituals, and both characters are unnerved by this information. Both players choose to kill her in the end, and it is revealed that she is a succubus. Now, a dialogue between the two characters reveals that they have found the amulet. They now decide to go back. Briliac the Mage invites Marcus to the magician's quarters. The player joins. A new quest has appeared for Briliac. He starts it, and the other player joins. Here are two choices. The mage chooses to give the amulet to the magician. The thief, however, chooses to keep it and kill the magicians. Here, keeping it overrules giving the amulet. Even on the mage side, who chose to give it, does not go through. The game is now complete. As in the game The Amulet, the story engine is constructed in these building blocks. Here we will try to make an addition to the game. We will add the marketplace as a new location. There are no prerequisites to enter this place. The NPC the players will talk to at the marketplace is the merchant, as seen in the green box. We will add two events. I've got a deal for you that the player can only enter with the prerequisite of introduced. The last event is introduction to the merchant, with no prerequisites. The action will introduce yourself and give the effect of introduced. Lastly, we will add a description to the first event, describing the event to the player, saying, "Hello, traveler, I have a deal that I would like to discuss with you." These blocks are transcribed to XML as seen here. Each XML element is passed through the engine's parser into data objects. At runtime, these elements will become game objects that the player can interact with. Here we have started the game and can see the player enter the new location. The only event that is available is the one without the prerequisite. After taking the action that we specified, the player now has the prerequisite introduced on the right side. Now the player can take the new event and see the description we put in. Here, no new implementation was needed in order to get these new elements into the game. On starting the game, everything will be loaded from this XML.